Her name, Hayley Westenra, and it's a fair bet few of you would have heard of that name until the release of a CD this week. It's a CD that sold so many copies to record stores that it was guaranteed to go gold even before the official release. Extraordinary? Well, this is a teenager with an extraordinary voice, a voice that defies her diminutive frame, a talent 60 Minutes has been following on the road to stardom. She's already being described as one of our greatest musical talents ever. Listen to Hayley Westenra at just 13. They're calling it the voice of an angel. A remarkable, spine-tingling, show-stopping quality for one so young.
I've met a lot of wonderful people, right through from Michael Jackson and Pavarotti, but to me, this is one of the most unique and talented persons I've ever come across.
Gray Bartlett has spent a lifetime in show business, performing and promoting. He's adamant Hayley is the find of his life.
You're quite taken.
I'm sold. Definitely sold. It's taken a long time, but I'm sold.
58 years.
58 years to find.
In her early teens, Hayley already has the poise, the professionalism of a talent decades older. Here at Auckland's Concert in the Park, not a hint of nerves in front of 200,000 people.
Is it nerve-wracking singing in front of those huge crowds?
In some ways, I mean, it's actually harder sometimes singing in front of your peers. Like when I sang at the school assembly, I was really actually nervous about that.
By day, she's just another fourth former at Burnside High in Christchurch.
A for litmus, B for phenolphthalein.
Oh, okay.
A straight-A student with a passion for not only music, but for languages and science.
Yeah, okay, so that's clear.
Still clear, isn't it?
Yeah, really, that science is so interesting, so it'd be cool to do something in science, but I don't know whether I would end up doing it. I'd probably start off with a music degree and maybe later do something in a different area like science, but I don't really know. That's it.
She may be the headline act in the Westenra family, but by no means the only star. This modest household is a hothouse of musical talent. There's little brother Isaac, and down the hallway, younger sister Sophie. Where did they get this talent?
That's probably from, your
parents. Definitely Jill's parents.
Gerald and Jill Westenra, the parenting skills backing this trio.
Because it's just not Hayley we're talking about. I mean, you've got two other very talented children. What's the secret?
I just think that, it's because we've encouraged them.
Provided the opportunities,
And just enjoyed what they're doing. First time you've got a baby and you're sort of, everything they do you're in awe of. Well, it hasn't really stopped. It's like everything they do, we're proud of.
This is a family that does everything together. A family that has a lot to be proud of. Hayley's not only a gifted singer, an accomplished student, she also plays the violin and, for a little bit of light relief, learns ballet.
Do you have to push her to go and do these things?
Push her to do it. You have to say, do you really want to do it?
Mm.
Because you know that in the end it'll be me rushing to get everything organised.
Yeah, they want to do so much, but we sometimes have to put the brakes on sometimes. But
so it doesn't feel like hard work.
No, you can get exhausted. You're exhausted after concert and like fitting in homework and everything. It can sometimes get really stressful. But I mean, if you didn't love what you're doing, you'd just sort of give up because. It's not that easy.
For Hayley and the other two members of the Westenra trio, this is relaxation. And busking is also an opportunity to make some serious pocket money. But it's that magic voice that becomes a crowd stopper. A voice that moves people in different ways. And the reward isn't just applause. In the hour 60 minutes filmed, the young trio earned $160 for this bit of busking.
What's it like when people come up to you in the street and say, "Who is that girl?"
Mm. That's great.
You must feel immensely proud.
Oh, yes, yes. But somehow people seem to work out that we are the parents, even though we try.
Even by the age of 11, she was a seasoned performer, a familiar face on the talent quest circuit. The parents knew she was good. They didn't know just how good.
You know, I've sort of thought that excitement that I'm feeling is just the adrenaline because it's my child performing. But there have been times where she's sung in the kitchen or the living room and you think, wow, gosh, you know.
She's singing in the living room here and, it just brought a tear to your eye, the emotion that was coming out of the song. Close your eyes,
give me your hand. A rare quality not lost on others. The demand for a recording of Hayley's voice was such that the help of a family friend, the Westenras cut a CD. A CD sent to Gray Bartlett.
I played it, and in all my years, I've never had a reaction to thinking this is a certain person that's going to really make it. And I was just overwhelmed by what I heard. It was just fantastic.
Mm-hmm. So just fade away with a could.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll try it one more time, please, right?
Gray would have Hayley back in a recording studio, this time with a contract with Universal Records. And the young kid from Christchurch was quickly surprising the pros. Hayley wasn't only impressing the world's biggest record company, but numerous overseas promoters and showbiz agents.
That's the key. I mean, the key is the voice.
Hollywood agent John Steele, a man who acts as a consultant for groups like the Eagles and the Supremes, signed to act for Hayley in America.
If you never see the face, you never hear, you just hear it on a radio, it's going to turn your ear. You're going to say, boy, who's that? You know, when you hear Barbara Streisand or someone like that, you recognize it right away. And there's certain notes she'll do or whatever, but it's a distinct voice. And I think Hayley possesses that as well.
Charlotte Church, the Welsh teenage sensation, has made millions, made Sony Music the dominant force in what the industry calls the crossover classical charts. Hayley's already being compared to her. Predictions are she could end Charlotte Church's dominance. After a two-year search, Universal believe Hayley's the performer who could put them back in the top spot.
We hope to make Universal number one, maybe on the back of Hayley. It may seem like a big statement now, but it is a possible, given that the field is very narrow, and we think Hayley has mass appeal.
You've been compared to Charlotte Church. What do you think of that?
I think I take it's a really real big compliment that I've been compared to Charlotte Church, because she's done so well, and being compared to her is, amazing compliment.
To Hayley, it may seem like a long road, but a process which began with a flight to Auckland and the search for the right image for a fourth form international superstar.
Yeah, I think so.
Hayley was a bit worried that, I'm not a model, and I'm not poppy looking enough, and perhaps I don't have the right image. And she thought, I'm just so ordinary, really. You know, and when they met her, they loved it. They loved her personality.
If Hayley didn't see it, well, the camera certainly captured it. A face to match the voice a record company's dream. In an industry where the sight is as important as the sound, Universal have doubled the original promotion budget for Hayley's debut. Make it here, they say, she can make it anywhere.
The record company is pushing you to become a star. Do you feel the pressure?
Yep, yeah, you do. And because they're sort of relying on you, because their jobs depend on it as well. It's not just sort of me, if you know what I mean. It's because, yeah, there's been so much work behind the whole thing. And, yeah, so, yeah, quite a bit does rely on me.
There's a big record company involved now. Do you worry about the possible exploitation of it?
I think there's a very negative image of record companies in the entertainment industry, but we haven't really struck that. It's been very supportive.
Do you ever find yourself thinking sometimes, I'd just like to be an ordinary teenager?
No, because you think, what are they doing that I'm not doing? And they might be going to the movies when I'm doing a concert. And I much prefer to be doing that concert, so, yeah.
Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday, dear Hayley!
Yet another milestone, 14 years old today. Hayley is taking her first steps towards adulthood and towards superstardom. This is a teenager with a very balanced head on that diminutive frame.
8, 9, 10.
A teenager who dreamed what seemed an impossible dream, a dream which increasingly looks like coming true.
Well, we don't really have any high expectations at all.
No.
Really. It's just,
but
don't you?
No, but it would be really exciting.
It'd be nice to do well, but if she doesn't, well, she's done well so far.
Yeah.
Early sales of a CD suggests it will be a major hit here. There are already talks about a release in Britain and America. Meantime, there's a New Zealand tour in August. You get the feeling already, the world's a stage for Hayley Westenra.
You love it?
Yeah.
You can't imagine life without music.
No. I don't know what I'd do.
Hayley's CD, released just 2 weeks ago, is set to go double platinum. That's more than 30,000 discs. And just a few days ago, it cracked number one. No other artist has ever sold so many copies in New Zealand in such a short time. Hayley's now planning to tour New Zealand in June, school holidays permitting.